open days, it has priority issues that I understand are the most important two issues, which is the economic crisis, how to fight against this crisis, and global warming issues, how to fight against climate change. But in addition to that, I believe the city diplomacy as a tool for building measures of confidence is as important as the others. It's a very important topic. As you will remember, the founding fathers of the European Union once said that the EU is not the union of states, but the union of peoples. In my view, this implies that the EU is more a union of regions and cities rather than a union of states. And being cities, local authorities, which implies citizens, are the backbone of this, or should be the backbone of this union. So let us talk what we could achieve as local authorities in Nicosia, why and how this diplomacy produced results. The military coup and the subsequent war, which took place in Cyprus in 1974 and created a completely divided island, ironically also created the conditions for cooperation between the two local authorities of Nicosia. In 1958, separate Turkish-Cypriot municipalities were formed, and since this was in conformity with the British policies pursued then, a legal basis was provided, and later on, separate municipalities in five major towns in Cyprus were envisaged in the constitution, in 1960. But the controversy around this issue continued. Therefore, when the war in 1974 divided Cyprus in a more concrete form, there were two municipalities in Nicosia without recognizing each other's official status and without any coordination among them. This is important to know. After the war, it's after 74 July, the treatment plant of the sewerage system of Nicosia, which was under construction, it was not completed yet. I call this the kidneys of the town. And I ask this question, can a human being survive without kidneys? Not properly. And it is same with the cities. If you don't have a sewerage system and you don't have a proper treatment plant to treat your effluent, that city cannot function properly. Therefore, there was a real need for cooperation for the completion and successful running of the system. In other words, the mutual need, I underline this, the mutual need necessitated cooperation for mutual benefit. After lengthy discussions, agreement was reached for the completion of the system, which in my view was a win-win situation. What do I mean by win-win situation is the following. The Greek Cypriot side became able to complete the system and start to see the immediate benefit out of this system, because the taxpayers were paying money all the time and they were not able to receive any service at all. So they started to see the immediate benefit. Well, was there any alternative for the Greek Cypriots to follow at that time? Another plan? Theoretically, perhaps possible, but practically and economically, definitely not feasible. Due to the topography of the city, it was necessitated that the treatment plant was going to be somewhere which it exists today. Then the Turkish side became able to solve an environmental hazard, because three factories were discharging their effluent into the riverbed just in the middle of the town without any prior treatment. So that was a real problem for us. And more than that, Turkish Cypriot side became part of the overall plan. In order to implement something, you need a project. In order to find funds, finance, you need a project. So with that scheme, we became part of the overall scheme, so that we started partially to have our working plans for future implementation. Did we have an alternative then? Of course. We could have our own system, a separate system, but that would mean a new, completely new project, more funds, more time. So both sides seemed to see that agreement was a better option for all the sides. Therefore, this cooperation was successful. Once we saw that the first steps in the sewerage system was successfully implemented, which I call this our underground cooperation, then we decided to get further above the ground to start a new cooperation, a perhaps a more challenging cooperation, which is Nicosia Master Plan. I call that cooperation above the ground. And mind you, these two projects under successive mayors, under successive local administration, still continue today. Nobody dared to stop these two projects. So what lessons could we derive out of these two successfully implemented projects? I would say, first, we learned that it is possible to cooperate even under complex situations and difficult times. I think Eleni also referred to this, that one shouldn't wait until after the overall solution, but should start cooperation immediately. Not to wait until after the overall solution of the Cyprus problem is achieved. If we see that there are partial solutions, why shouldn't we tackle those? I give you an example. If we hadn't moved in this direction, what would have been the fate of the very interesting and with architectural value of the walled city of Nicosia? It could have been destroyed. But now we have a very good example of how to restore it and rehabilitate the heart of our city, even under complex situations. And one more important point is that we foreseen for many years ago, in the year 1986, Lelos took the initiative to pedestrianize a part in his park. It's called Litra and Onasagoru Streets, whereas I took the initiative in 1986 to pedestrianize Arasta and surrounding nearby streets, hoping one day that Litra crossing, which had been a symbol of division, perhaps one day will be reopened and will be a symbol of reunification. If we didn't take this action, you know what was going to happen? On one side, people would be in the pedestrian zone, free of traffic, free of noise, and free of everything, and would jump into a traffic jam once we opened the Litra Street. So now people are very smoothly going shopping, sitting in the streets and so on. This was made possible because of this vision. Well, I know that I'm about to conclude with my time. I want to say a few more things and give room for your questions so that we can elaborate more if you ask questions about Nicosia. I think one of the basic starting points is the existence of mutual need. That's why I said the division, although we want to see it, the division, the continuation of division in our country, but we have to be fair and say that in Nicosia case, division ironically created the conditions for cooperation for mutual benefit. Because before that, there wasn't such a a willingness to cooperate, because the two sides didn't recognize each other and they didn't want to know about each other and so on and so forth. Anyway, besides this, I think the existence of the mutual need is not enough. It's one of the basic elements, but it's not enough. You need leadership qualities. You need empathy to be in a position to try to understand the other party, to try to be in his shoes. Public support. You need to inform your people at every stage. They should know what you are doing and what for, and within what time frame you are doing what you are doing. Therefore, media is very, very important. I must say that in my case, in the north, they were not very, very helpful. From time to time, I was under political attack for some reasons. International interest, international support, attitudes of the central governments are also important elements. I hope in Nicosia case, I will again refer to my country, of course, in the Nicosia case, we were able to implement this city diplomacy and produce some results. In my view, I repeat again, the basic element for that, besides the foxes and that kind of, was the mutual need that existed, which forced this come together. Otherwise, this cooperation wouldn't have materialized. This is my strong view that I stick to that. But I want to go beyond that and say, forget about formalities, as you say, forget about recognition and so on. Why don't the other municipalities in Cyprus come together, and why don't they cooperate? Why shouldn't we ask this question and force for an immediate cooperation? Just following the same example, for instance, we have the Union of Municipalities on both sides. They have a lot of things in common. A lot. Why shouldn't they come together and try to pave the way for the eventuality? The eventuality, in my view, is that the Turkish Cypriots will also become a part of the European Union. Dear friend, I would very much wish to be able, like you, to speak my own language here instead of English. As a Turkish Cypriot, if the solution of the Cyprus problem was achieved, say, 4 years ago or 5 years ago, we would have been a part as community in the Union, and the Turkish language was also going to become an official language of the European Union. And I would be able to speak in my own language. But I hope that they eventually will come. But the question is, what shall we do? Shall we sit idle and wait until that day comes? Or if we do things now, at the same time, we will be helping to achieve that eventuality. I give you just a concrete example. Say garbage recycling. On both sides of the divide, it is landfill, still. In Cyprus, it's land. Why shouldn't the municipalities, all the Cypriot municipalities, both Greek Cypriot and Turkish Cypriot, why shouldn't they come under a organization to start the modern recycling process also in Cyprus, like the way it is done in European countries? We can have a lot of other examples. Another example, which is also related with this climate change, you know that water in Cyprus is the most scarce element. And nowadays there are projects underway to bring in water under the sea via pipes from Turkey. I don't know if that's going to be feasible. If it is going to be feasible, I wish that it will benefit both communities one day. But why wait that one day? Today, You know the Limnitis area, Yeşil Irmak Limnitis area in Cyprus? 10 million cubic meter of water is running into the sea annually. If there could be a cooperation between the two sides, it is possible and feasible to construct a dam where we can collect this water for the usage of both sides. And these kind of things should not wait until after the solution. We can do them now. We can create this cooperation, and it will also help for achieving the solution. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.